"Have you had any unpleasant adventures?" asked my wife. It was in vain to attempt replying to so many questions and exclamations. At length, when we had got a little peace, I told them that, though I had brought them all sorts of good things, I had unfortunately not met with any of our companions.
"God's will be done," said my wife. "Let us thank him for saving us, and again bringing us together now. This day has seemed an age. But put down your loads, and let us hear your adventures. We have not been idle, but we are less fatigued than you. Boys, assist your father and brother."
Jack took my gun, Ernest the coconuts, Francis the gourd rinds, and my wife the game bag. Fritz distributed his sugar canes and placed the monkey on Turk's back, to the amusement of the children. He begged Ernest to carry his gun, but he complained of being overloaded with the great bowls. His indulgent mother took them from him, and we proceeded to the tent. Fritz thought Ernest would not have relinquished the bowls if he had known what they contained, and called out to tell him they were coconuts.
"Give them to me," cried Ernest. "I will carry them, Mama, and the gun too."
His mother declined giving them.
"I can throw away these sticks," said he, "and carry the gun in my hand."
"I would advise you not," observed Fritz, "for the sticks are sugar canes."
"Sugar canes!" cried they all, surrounding Fritz,
who had to give them the history and teach them the art of sucking the canes. My wife, who had a proper respect for sugar in her housekeeping, was much pleased with this discovery, and the history of all our acquisitions, which I displayed to her. Nothing gave her so much pleasure as our plates and dishes, which were actual necessaries. We went to our kitchen, and were gratified to see preparations going on for a good supper. My wife had planted a forked stick on each side of the hearth. On these rested a long, thin wand, on which all sorts of fish were roasting, Francis being entrusted to turn the spit.